Hey, what's up, art lovers? It's SP. Welcome to my amazing art channel. In this channel, I upload how to draw portrait drawings. So if you are new to my channel, hit that subscribe button and don't forget to press that bell icon. It's free, man. So in today's video, I'm going to draw Sania Malhotra. She's an amazing and beautiful and so much talented Bollywood actress. You better know her from her appearance and a best role in Dangal. No, I'm not talking about wrestling, I'm talking about movie Dangal. As you can see that I'm starting this sketch from hairs. From this reference picture, you can see that her hairs are totally curvy and darker and lighter portions are there. Just see the strokes I'm giving for any other strokes and curvy nature of these hairs. Your pencil strokes will look like a snake. Yes, you heard it right. I said snake. From the reference picture, you can imagine that her eyebrows are a little bit of darker on the middle of portions. And from the right hand side, as I have always said that, always see highlights and shadows. The lighter portions are on right side of her face and darker portion are on her left side of her face. Now you can focus on hairs and curvature. As I said earlier that you can use a snake type of strokes for that. Now I'm focusing on her left eye. I'm just darkening the darker portions of her cornea and her lips. I will do it later. For her right eye, as you can see from reference picture that it looks pretty similar as of left eye. What I mean about saying darker portions in eyes and similarities that both looks darker in middle and lighter in right hand side. For darkening the face and any other detailed portions, always see reference by side and do it again and again for a detailed and easy realistic sketch. As you can see from reference picture, sometimes and some portions of her hair looks like a spring and some portions look like snake. But to do a curly and any other type of hair types, you can always go for snake. As I said that, go for snake type. If you want a particular video for curvy nature of hair, how to draw for curvy nature, you can comment down below. I will make separate video for that. If you want to buy good quality of blending stumps, you can find it on my description of this video. Now I'm just blending darker portions. Now focus what I said. I am saying that darker portions of hair. Now as you can see on her lips, the darker portion are too low on her sides of lips, not every part. As I said earlier that her lighter portions and light sources on right side. So as I have always said that darker and shadowed portion will be on left side. As you can see that her lower lip is little bit of darker inside. So I'm just shading little bit of portion. I'm not shading every part of lips. If I will go for darker portions on lips, it will look totally weird. As you can see from reference picture that her lips are light in nature. I left nose and unblended, as you can see that. I've just shaded, or I can say that sharpened pencil, I have used charcoal pencil on her face. As you can see on her right cheek, there are a little bit of portion of hairs that I drawn from charcoal pencil, but they are light in nature. Focusing on her only hand that is shown or is visible in this picture, I'm just outlining every part that is visible. Now as you can see that darker portions are too much on the left side of these hairs, or you can say that down side of these hairs, from neck to left side of her hairs. Now you can see that the snake type that I said for curly hairs, it's visible and it looks really cool for curly hairs. If you're looking for good quality charcoal pencils, I've given some or you can say that good quality charcoal pencils in my description. You can buy from there. I'm not blending any other part right now, as I'm just shading, or I can say that directly giving snake type of or a curly type of strokes or darker strokes. For curly hairs, you will or you have to always focus on the stroke types. As you can see that sometimes I'm just using spiral, or I can say that any other spring type of shading portions, or sometimes, as you can see on the left side of this portion, I'm using snake type of curly hairs. It is useful for me, or if you want to know how to do it, I will make a separate video. Just comment down below. From reference picture, it is clearly visible that darker portion is on her left side of her neck and lighter portions is totally on right side. You can see the harder and harder strokes on her hairs and so many spaces in between them. But it looks totally bad, but it will be out of these portions while I will blend them. As you can see that I'm just filling that spaces in between them. If you can see the from reference picture and the picture I am drawing, you can see that so many differences there are there. She's wearing a black type of something, so I'm just darkening it with a charcoal pencil. Darkening it, it will make it totally different from any other thing. Blending fills any other spaces that are between them. So blending any other cloth part is okay, but for that, if you are using a charcoal pencil, it will always leave a harder portions. So blending stumps are very useful in that. You can use earbuds too, but earbuds are too small and it will leave too many marks for harder portions. You can go for shading his total face and darkening any other portions, but I use using lighter portions. As you can see that paper is totally white, so why not using it for darker and lighter portions different? Shading full face, but face doesn't look totally different from reference picture, it doesn't mean anything. So what I recommend you all is that just focus on lighter and darker portions. If the face look perfect, go for little bit of shading first. Layering it will also helpful, but layering is for advanced people. If you have done 1000 or 500 sketches, then layering is very good for you. But if you are starting sketching portraits and going for layer to layer to layer, it will be a too hard portions for you. Just go for basics. Just make a picture first, her outlines first, then go for any other techniques or any other things. I'm using grid method for perfections, or you can say that her face structures or any other face structures for portraits. If you want to know how to use a grid method, just comment down below. I will make a particular sketch for that. As you can compare the picture and a reference picture and my drawing, that it looks too similar from drawing and the picture, but the dissimilarities is that the darker and spaces portions are literally visible right now. So I'm just starting blending every other parts so that after blending it will look totally different from that. Biggest mistake people do while drawing a portrait is that they do layering, they do shading, they do highlights and many other techniques and everything, but their face of a portrait doesn't look similar to a reference page. What was the need for that if your portrait is doesn't looking like a reference picture? Just give another 1 hour and your portrait will look totally different. As you can see that the spaces are filling up and the portrait is looking too good. After I will blend a total sketch, it will look totally different from what I said earlier. As a portrait artist, you should always go for first her face or a portrait sketch face first. It will look totally different or it will look totally same. It totally depends on how you sketch them. Shading or any other highlighting thing is totally second side. First go for perfection. Now I'm just blending every other part of hair that I have left, and you can see that reference picture and the picture I am drawing right now. it's almost complete. It looks totally good and similar to reference picture. Now I'm just darkening any other portions that I have left, and space is filling up. Spacing filling in curly hairs is too much important thing. The hairs that I have detailed, not a detailed thing, I can say that. Detailing in curly hairs are too much important. I'm doing too fast these curly hairs. If you want to know how to make a curly hairs, just comment down below. I'll make a particular tutorial for that. You can see that after filling up spaces, it looks totally good. If you are new to portrait sketching, just go for basic pencils like Apsara or any other things. You can find any other things in my descriptions if you want. Don't go for charcoal at first. If you like this video, just subscribe, and thanks for watching. I'll see you in my next video.